So what are metallic papers and why should we be using them to print our images? Hello and welcome to this Fotospeed video with me, Tim Jones. Today what we're going to be looking at is metallic papers and why we should think about using them. Now, metallic papers aren't going to be for everyone. However, they are well worth trying. Now, I've got a few pictures here that I'm going to talk through and why I kind of think they work well with metallic papers. So hopefully set you on the right track of choosing which images to print on these papers. Now, here at Fotospeed, we offer two types of metallic papers, the metallic luster and the metallic gloss. Both are fantastic. I would say the metallic luster is a little bit slightly warmer than the gloss, but both do an absolutely fantastic job. Now, a little bit of housekeeping. As always, please don't forget to subscribe. Just click in the bottom right there. Just click that subscribe button. Now, also stick around to the end of the video because I will have a discount code that will give 15% off Fotospeed papers. So let's get started and let's have a look at some prints and find out what works best on metallic papers. So, first image is probably my kind of what I think about when I think about metallic papers is a really bright, colourful picture, really kind of vibrant colours in there, and a deep black. That's what I kind of think about when I think about metallic paper. Now, because we're laying ink over the coating of the metallic, so anything that's white will have a little bit more of a sheen to it than anything with ink on, we are losing or subduing the metallic kind of effect over this picture here, because there's not much white actually in the image itself. However, you might think that's a bad thing. However, what the metallic kind of finish does is it intensifies the color. So it really makes it pop and stand off the page. So it almost looks a bit 3D-ish. Again, I think metallic papers are one of the really good examples of a paper actually affecting an image and can really add to an image when it comes off the printer in kind of print form. So that's why I think they're well worth having a look at. Now, I kind of came to metallic papers a little bit late because I always thought I never really knew what to print on them. And I was always a little bit, not scared of them, but possibly that could be the right word. And I thought, well, I don't really know. You've got to have a certain type of image to print on it. You've got to have like something with metal in or something like that, or cars and things. Where actually, most images will work quite well on them. And it's just about trying it and having a look and seeing kind of what your results are. Like I said, they're not for everyone. However, it's well worth a try because you may have seen them at a show or seen them somewhere and thought, what am I going to print on that? Well, best thing to do is just print something on it and have a look and see if you like it. Now, another type of picture that I think works really, really well on metallic papers are black and white pictures. They work fantastically, especially if you've got a bit of a contrasty image, because they work really well because that white and the black play off against each other and you kind of get that metallic sheen in there and it works fantastically and lovely. I've picked a bit of a wedding picture here though, something a little bit different to be honest, that you probably wouldn't think of metallic papers and kind of what you would use to print. Now, wedding pictures look great, or kind of pictures with detail in look great on metallic papers because there's white in there, and a bit like the veil here, it could have got lost on other papers. However, on the metallic paper, because of that little bit of sheen in the finish, it's just picked it out a little bit and really made it will pop, shall we say. And also, if you put it to the side, they just have that lovely finish and sheen over the top, and you get that kind of glistening feel over the top. Perhaps not for the whole wedding album, shall we say, but maybe as a cover print or something like that. Just something to make this image stand out among the rest, shall we say. Another image that works really well is something with water in. If you've got a reflection down here, it works really well. You've got flowing water going through something. Or you've got lovely still water, flat, a long exposure with loads of still water in. Looks fantastic. Now, I've picked this picture because it's quite a bright landscape with a nice reflection in here. So it's made all those colours look absolutely fantastic, but it's also added something to the picture as well, because you've almost got that possibly that little feel of that mirror effect because of the sheen and that metallicness of the paper in there. So again, landscapes work really well. You've got to pick the right landscape, something with a lot of contrast or a lot of bold colour in there seems to work quite well. If you've got a kind of a muted palette, it probably won't work that well on here. But saying that, give it a go. It may give you the correct effect you're looking for. It may give you the right effect you're looking for. So don't ever rule anything out. Give it a try. Now, the last picture I did was one of mine, actually, from a series I'm doing using multiple digital negatives, laid on top of each other. And then I'm using a LumaPrint process to create the image. Now, a bit more abstract, a little bit different, still with bold colour though. But actually, it wasn't as intense as this actually on the screen. It was a little bit more muted. So when I've printed it, the metallic nature of the paper has actually intensified that colour for me. And also the birds, when I get it on a slight angle, they just have this glistening kind of effect, which actually I really like. It wouldn't have been my first paper choice, to be honest, to print this on. Now, I might have gone for a cotton-based matte paper or possibly something like the Legacy or something like that. However, the metallic paper is beautiful. It looks really, really nice. Now I'm going to have a slight play and carry on and just see what I can get out of these metallic papers. Now it may be I start looking at another paper that isn't a Fotospeed paper, but it's a Haarlemuller product, and it's called the Photo Rag Metallic. Now it's probably one of the most expensive papers in the world, but it is absolutely beautiful. So it may be I might try and get a sample of that and have a play with these images and see what they look like on that paper. But yeah, it certainly opened my mind, should I say, to different things. Now, I hope that's been useful. Now, like I said, a little bit of a short video this week, but it was something I wanted to do and talk about metallic papers, just because sometimes it applies to all papers, to be honest, this, that in sometimes just give the paper a try, just print something on it, because you may like it. A bit like my abstract picture here, actually, it's come to life a little bit, and I want to explore that. And I'm going to start doing some test prints on different types of metallic, should we say. Go try one on the Luster, actually, and also the Photo Rag Metallic from Haarlemuller as well. Now, maybe it will take the work to a different level and it will become something else, which is absolutely fantastic. And I think that is what paper can give you. It can give you that different level, that something else you might be looking for in an image. So give it a try. Now, the metallic papers feature in our photo range test pack. Now, you get three sheets of each, the metallic gloss and the metallic luster, so you can have a bit of a play around in there as well. Now, at the start of the video, I said there was a 15% voucher. Now, that voucher is FSYouTube15. Now, you don't have to use that on metallic papers. It works on all Fotospeed papers on photospeed.com. So jump on and order some papers if you're looking for some. Also, as always, please don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up. And also put any comments below that if you've had a kind of a play around with metallic papers and what you found, what kind of works best as well. Because like I said, there's no real rules to paper choice. It's kind of what suits you. And like I said at the start, this may not be for everyone, but it's worth having a try and having a look. Okay, so until next time, bye-bye.